Friends, I welcome you all to the consultative meet of the South Asia Regional Forum on Safe and Secure Education. Today we have with us Honorable Minister of State, Independent Charge, Housing and Urban Affairs, Sri Hardeep Singh Puri, as the chief guest. I welcome you, sir. Professor Muchkund Dubey, Mentor of the RTE Forum and President of Council for Social Development. Ms. Stuti Kakkar, Chairperson of National Commission for Protection of Child Rights. Mr. Eric Fall, Director and UNESCO, Representative to Bhutan, India, Maldives, and Sri Lanka. Mr. Kumar Bhattarai, Chairperson of National Campaign for Education, Nepal, and the Steering Committee Member of the South Asia Regional Forum. Ms. Radhika Alkaji, she is the National Council Member of RTE Forum and also a Steering Committee Member. Mr. Aminul Haq, Deputy Director of Program, Swedish Committee of Afghanistan. Ms. Papia Fardosi, Program Manager, BRAC Education Program, Bangladesh. Mr. Rahmatullah Arman, Gulmakai Champion, Malala Fund, Afghanistan. And other important leaders from different social movements, networks, educationists, and activists. It gives me great pleasure to witness that so many of you have taken the time off your busy schedule to join us today. And this makes me confident that all of us united by the cause of safe and secure education for all. It has also given us the encouragement to keep advocating for the purpose with support from all of you. Right to education is now a fundamental right in India, and RTE Act, which came into effect in 2010, mandates that all children between age group of 6 to 14 years will have free and compulsory education. The RTE Act was the cornerstone for improving the education scenario in the country. However, 8 years since its inception, we have seen less than 10% school complying with its provisions. There still exist huge vacancy. 5 lakh post vacant. 5 lakh posts are vacant for the teachers. 9 lakh teacher still untrained. 8% single teacher schools. Lack of clean drinking water in the schools. Poor infrastructure. Issue of timely disbursement of teaching learning materials. Lack of adequate resources are some of the persistent problems that affect the learning environment in schools. Alongside, we have recently seen that a large number of schools in India are being shut down in the name of rationalization. Private entities coming into the education space, leading to mushrooming of low-cost, pro-private, profit, private schools. After the enactment of the RTE Act, we have achieved an increase in enrollment, but still millions of children who are either out of school or dropping out from the school before completing their elementary education. As a result of these challenges, all children are not able to enjoy their right to free and compulsory education even after 8 years of the enactment of RTE Act. Those who are deprived for this right mostly belong to the marginalized groups, children with disability, and especially girls. The RTE Act guarantees the protection of right of children. Needless to say, every child deserves a safe and secure education for a safe and secure environment for education. However, the reality gives a different picture. Data reveals that several girls drop out of school due to poor safety conditions within the school environment, lack of separate toilets for girls and boys, distance of travel between their homes and schools. Other factors also play a role, like engagement in domestic chores, taking care of a younger sibling, early marriages, and in general the patriarchal mindset that does not prioritize girls' education. Recently, we have seen several reports from across the country which highlights the plight of girls both within the school as well as out of the school. This shows the lack of effective protective mechanisms. All this is true not just for India, but other South Asian countries as well. apart from the issues of safety and security, there are other important and common areas like the universalization of school education, adequate resources, equity and inclusion, teachers' issues, increasing commercialization of education, recently developed sustainable development goals, which provide us opportunity to work together in South Asia region. Today we will hear similar grassroots level experiences and national voices from the participants from neighboring countries. It is high time that these challenges are addressed, and all of us gathered here today can take a place to make this issue a prime agenda in our respective countries as well as at the regional level while working in education, human rights, and women empowerment, etc. The South Asia Regional Forum on Safe and Secure Education was envisioned to form a collective voices on the similar issues, provide an opportunity for cross-learning, and influence policy discourse in South Asian region. The forum was formed after several deliberations with representatives from neighboring countries. In 2017, during the national stocktaking of RTE forum, we have launched it. After that, we have launched it in Nepal, and now we are moving towards Bangladesh and Afghanistan. So these are the common issues where we want to work together, and it all depending on the strengthening of the national movements in respective countries. So I would like to welcome all of you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, Ambrish.